So in fun talking, fun speak, I'm going to talk about, I don't know, I guess I'm reminiscing on neoclassical, on ballet a little bit. It's a dangerous addiction a little bit. Now, when it began, it's the scandal, and I'm like, well, can a little town America ever handle a tense, I'll call it the neoclassical version of, you know, American Nutcracker style, or, you know, the original Nutcracker style. Could it handle it? You know, is it just so much, you know, you have to deal with liberals and Republicans. That's it, you know, and so are you just, you're cutting out half of your, are you going to be cutting out half of your audience like that, you know? So is that why we always have to stay with that? So I haven't been real pushy with the neoclassical, because I'm, you know, it's kind of, how can I say it? It's kind of glib sometimes, and a little audacious, and I don't know. It has a chance, though, to push the philosophies of life through quite a bit more, and it is, you know, the current. It tries to be as much current as possible. So it is kind of, you know, allowed in Europe. Europe has been allowed this freedom to have it. I don't want it to stop. As much as maybe I complained about it or whatever, I don't ever want it to stop. I think it's amazing, and the. Yeah, like Berendt even, you know, what he was doing at the time, even before Béjart was getting pouncy with it, he was there first. He was there first making audacious productions. And it's all about the audience, you know, about drawing that audience in. Are you going to come and watch? Are you going to come and see it? You know, how are we going to entertain you during that time frame? To that time frame, you know, how are we going to, you know, you hear that music again and again and again, you know, how are we going to entertain you? That's all it is, you know. You know, is it worth the ticket? Again, you know, to watch them go this way and go that way every year, this way and then that way every year. You know, is it worth it, the ticket? You know, do they need it? You know, do they need the extra? For some reason, the Europeans are loving the extra. They love the scandal of it. They may want to, you know, watch a real old-style one occasionally, but I believe they love the scandal of it, because it is so, like, current with the times, rather than the old heritage of the past. So, yeah, I don't know. I get a little sad here, because I know America is just not capable of having it like that. They just seem a little stunted. Yeah, a little stunted. And it's just like, well, when will they be able to? When will they be able to actually handle, you know, a production that has a whole bunch of different variables, you know, completely different. When will they be able to handle it? Maybe never, I'm starting to think. It just seems like, you know, I went away for a while there, long time, I guess I've been over there, maybe, seems, like I said, maybe 15 years or so. But when, I know that little montage, I didn't include the last bit, the last 10 or so, 15 years, not really. So gosh dang it, yeah, when I'm talking about I am so fraught with this nuclear at the moment, I swear to gosh, it's fripping our brains, you know, around, you know, the water, like it's hypercharging the water in our bodies. What a terrible thing to fiddle with. What a terrible thing that they even invented and had. proliferation like this. So what it was I was going to say was I was talking about, I know I'm going to make another video about that since I'm such an ultra scientist, but it was about the arts itself, you know. Yeah, I know it's really tedious, a tedious chore to watch another Clara production, you know. Maybe it's okay, you know, the very first time for a child to see it. And I guess that's all you're really supplying is the very first time for people who've ever been to ballet. Maybe that's all Nutcracker is. Maybe that's all dance is here, is the very first time they've ever gone. You know, that production has to be. So, and that's unfortunate. That's unfortunate. Don't they get bored? You know, there's again another, and then the audience that goes back, you know, don't they get bored? Like, well, I think we've passed that point. We want to see something else, don't we? Yeah, we want to see something. We want to see, you know, spicier lights. We want to see neato bonito backgrounds. They have the neatest backdrops nowadays. I mean, you can put the whole Grand Canyon behind you if you want, or the space shuttle. You can do all kinds of things. You can be underneath a little tiny daisy. I mean, all kinds of things can exist really quickly. But, yeah. So I'm kind of bummed out because I just don't know how you're going to draw that audience in, because it's so, in a weird way, it's kind of the Ringling Brothers, Barnum and Bailey type of a event. You know, it has that chaotic interrupt, you know, hello, can you focus, you know, for this variation, you know, to the audience. It's saying again and again, hello, wake up. Can you focus to this? And you know, it's just like pinch. You know, it's like an Italian pinch. You know, you're walking down the street, and an Italian man pinches you out of the blue, and you're like, oh my God, you know, how'd that happen? You know, it's a shock. So it's these little shock variations. You know, the shock variations. You know. And I'm not sure the audience wants to be shocked either. So I'm just kind of in like, I don't know, it's like a tandem place, because I'm like, well, Germany is amazing because they're accepted for it. They're accepting it, and they're open to it, you know, and I just feel like this is just such a what do you call it, like a backwater, Arkansonian play state in the people's minds. They're just like, no, you just do the little dance, and then that's it, and then we go home, everybody goes home. You know. So yeah, I don't know. I'm kind of sad because the future is so, it's so like Blade Runner having, wanting and Pandoric and just episodic and alive, and quandaries flying, and we're just not allowed that here. We're not allowed that here on stage. The audience is just like, what? No, we just want to watch the same. We want to watch the football. We want to watch the Nutcracker the same way. We want to watch the football. And then, was there anything else? No. Just seems like this like deadhead brains. What do they call that? That one is called culture, and the other one is called sports. Yeah. So anyway, so I'm working on my little Samsara fellow. I did not put an Asian dancer in the last book, but this book is gonna have an Asian, and I'm having problems with his feet, but oh my gosh, yeah, he lives underneath a Samsara tree, and yeah, I'm kind of loving him. And so anyway, so that's what I'm doing at the moment. All right, so yeah, I'm sad for neoclassical here in America. And yeah, that was a kind of a horrible production of Béjart. I'll say that again. Like if I was a reviewer there, the critiquer there, that was horrible. I hated that with the woman there on the stage, that model. I hated it. I still hate it to this day. It wasn't necessary. It wasn't necessary. It was kind of, I don't know, immature. It was immature compared to Berndt's production. Berndt's production was far superior. He used different modes of dancing. He used more modern, even, you know. Yeah, I wasn't happy with it. It was just kind of a glut of furniture on the stage, wasn't it? Yeah. Anyway. So of all of them so far, Berndt is winning. Amazing. I liked Pierre's though. I liked Pierre's Nutcracker. I won't say no. Pierre's was very good. Yeah. It was a very good production. Yeah, who came first, chicken or the egg? I guess it was at that point it was Pierre. Pierre was making them. And so we're going to have to give a lot of kudos that direction. And Hans von Mannen also was going pretty nutty, making the bald swans. So, yeah. Congratulations to Mr. Weiss. Yeah. Neoclassicist. Yeah. Yikes. Oh my gosh, I did see one dancer in his production though. Just tump on the stage. That was funny. She did all those fouettes. One of the fairies, one of the main sugar fairies, sugar plum fairies. She pulled in. She was good at pulling in four or five sometimes, and she went for it and just tumped right on her caputi. And oh my goodness. I felt so sorry for her, but it was no big deal. No big deal. She got up and kept going. Yeah, she was a French woman. Funny.